the beautiful words of Allah that were repeated in the previous surah. In the previous surah, Allah said, فَذَكِّرْ إِنَّ فَعَتِ الذِّكْرَى. Remind if reminder has a benefit. Here he says, فَذَكِّرْ إِنَّمَا أَنْتَ مُذَكِّرْ. Basically, Allah is giving tafsir of the previous ayah. In Surah Al-A'la, Allah said, remind if benefit serves to have any if reminder serves to have any benefit. Now, he goes a step further and explains what that means. Then remind. Again, no object has been mentioned. No, remind them. فَذَكِّرْهُمْ. No. فَذَكِّرْ. No object. In other words, whether somebody listens or not, what do? Remind. You just remind. That's your job. That's it. Don't worry about what effect it has on people. Maybe it'll have an effect, maybe it won't have an effect. Maybe it'll have an effect much, much later. Abu Sufyan becomes a Muslim a lot later, right? But he heard it a lot earlier. The magicians with Musa alayhi salam heard the message a lot earlier, but then when they saw a miracle eventually, they accepted Islam. And they understood to make sajda, they knew they have the akhirah is coming, they knew all of that because they heard the message already. So, فَذَكِّرْ إِنَّمَا أَنْتَ مُذَكِّرْ. You are nothing more than a reminder, a deliverer of reminder, mudakkir. You are nothing more than a deliverer of reminder. This has been is summarizing the career of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Once again, the work of da'wah is boiled down to the work of reminding human beings. In other words, reminding them of the past failures of past human beings, that's a memory. Reminding them of what Allah has informed them of the future. Reminding them of the covenant they had made with Allah already. Before they even came on this earth, they made a covenant. Remember that covenant? أَلَسْتُ بِرَبِّكُمْ قَالُوا بَلَا شَهِدْنَا. Reminding them of the inner conscience that tells them themselves this is wrong and this is right. Reminding them to know their honor that Allah has bestowed upon them as human beings. Then Allah adds, لَسْتَ عَلَيْهِمْ بِمُسَيْطِرْ. You know, in the previous surah Allah said, the only one who will benefit from reminder is the one who fears himself. سَيَذَّكَّرُ مَنْ يَخْشَى. That was in Surah Al-A'la. Now he says, you are not at all over them. You have not been placed upon them as a musaytir. What is a musaytir? Al-musallatu ala shay'in liyushrifa alayhi wa yata'ahada ahwalahu wa yaktubu amalahu. The good definition of al-musaytir. A musaytir is someone placed in charge, diligently in charge over someone, so that he may monitor every single thing that he does, control everything that he does, and to record all of its activities. Like a guard in prison, it's not just guarding the gate, but guarding the guy himself. He can't do anything unless the guard, the watchman over him, lets him. So the Messenger of Allah is told, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you can't force them. You can't watch over them and guard them and pull them into the Jannah. And what this illustrates is, you would think this is condescending to the Messenger, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, or Allah is scolding his Messenger, alayhi wasallam. None at all. This is not the case. What's happening here is it illustrates the Messenger is so worried, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, about these disbelievers who are in the end his people. They're in the end Quraysh. He's so worried that if the words don't work, he wants to pull them into Islam. But imagine, he's not in a position of power, they are. He's only in a position to give words. He doesn't have any military at his disposal. But he's still willing to go and literally try to force them to accept out of desperation and good for them. Allah says, no, you don't have to worry that much for them. You haven't been sent as a guardian over them to watch every one of their moves. لَسْتَ عَلَيْهِمْ بِمُسَيْطِرْ. You can't force them. And this occurs in another place, Allah Azza wa Jal in Surah Qaf, He says, وَمَا أَنْتَ عَلَيْهِمْ بِجَبَّارِ. You are not, you know, in any way, shape or form going to force them at all. You are not placed as one, you haven't been installed as someone who can force them in any way. The reminder in and of itself is enough. They have to find it in themselves. That's it. And this is, by the way, a beautiful illustration of لا إِكْرَاهَ فِي الدِّينِ. There's no forcing anyone in the religion. You can't force them. Even the Messenger is told, you're not there to force them. You're just there to, nothing more than remind. Remind, remind, remind. Now imagine the power of reminder. Imagine the power of reminder, subhanAllah, in the context of our deen. That you hear a khutbah, you hear a speech, you say, I've already heard this. But you know Allah says, فَذَكِّرْ إِنَّ فَعَتِ الذِّكْرَى. فَذَكِّرْ وَإِنَّ الذِّكْرَى تَنْفَعُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. Reminder will benefit believers. Reminder helps. Even if you know. You know you have to study for a test, but you're not doing it. And your friend comes over and says, man, you better study. And you go, yeah, you're right, I should. And you go start studying. Didn't you know you have to study? You did. But did the reminder benefit? It helped you. Right? This is a need of the human being to benefit from a reminder. SubhanAllah.